Do you ever feel like you've got a mountain of work to do, but no time to do it? We all do. So today I want to show you 10 super useful productivity tips for ChatGPT to get your work done faster. These tips are perfect for writers, marketers, content creators, communications professionals, basically anyone who uses words to make a living. If you're new here, I'm Aga. I run an online education business with more than 1.5 million followers across my social media platforms. And on this channel, I share my top tips on content, AI, and productivity. So please hit the subscribe button and let's get started. Tip number one, making checklists. If you've got a task or a little project to do, but you don't know where to start, you can ask ChatGPT to make you a checklist. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm just going to add this prompt into ChatGPT. Make me a checklist for writing a sales page for a new product. Let's see what it comes up with. Obviously, this is a very basic prompt, but I just want to demonstrate to you what it could look like. And then you can work on the prompt to refine it and to make it more specific to what you need. So we've got a good checklist here. We've got several different sections in this checklist. Define your foundation, craft a compelling headline, and so on. And we've got different action points by each category. So that already looks really helpful. Let's have a look at some more examples. Make me a checklist for running a webinar about social media marketing. So we've got some really useful points about webinar preparations, when to start them, some action points relating to identifying your target audience and setting up email reminders. So you can see that the checklist is very detailed and it contains lots of different action points under each category. So you can look at that as your starting point and then refine the prompt or refine the checklist itself once you know exactly what you need. Now you've got a step-by-step map instead of feeling lost, and you've saved lots of time by not having to think about what the process should look like or forgetting one of the steps along the way. Tip number two, summarizing long stuff. Are you reading a long article or report? You can use this prompt. Summarize this article in 5 bullet points. So let's look at an example. I'm actually going to use an article that I wrote a few years ago about why startup founders should learn foreign languages. It's quite a long article, so instead of reading every single word, I'm going to ask ChatGPT to summarize it for me. So I'm going to paste the article here with the following prompt. Summarize this article in 5 bullet points. And let's see what it comes up with. Learning a foreign language opens up unique market insights. It strengthens competitive advantage. That is exactly what I covered in the article. So that is a really useful starting point, especially if you need to do lots of research into something and you've got lots of articles or research papers to get through. This can be really useful. And it's something that can help you decide whether or not you want to read a little bit more about the topic. So you can read through the bullet points and then identify the things that you want to focus on in your research going forward. Now you actually have some time to have lunch or just do some more work. Tip number three, speed up your research. Imagine you need to do some research into how to organize a team building day or how to run a team member's performance review for the first time or to decide whether or not your company should start a new YouTube channel. You'll need to do some research first, but you can significantly speed up this process by asking ChatGPT. So let's imagine I'm doing some research into franchising. I want to understand what it means in the restaurant sector. So I'm going to ask ChatGPT to give me a little explanation of the topic and also provide some real world examples. So my prompt is going to be, give me a short explanation of franchising in the restaurant sector with 3 real world examples, and let's see what it comes up with. So it's given me a very plain and straightforward definition of what it means and how it works, and it's also given me some 3 real world examples using very famous international brands. So I can then use that and do a little bit more research into those specific brands if I want to find out more how they do it. Of course, you can still do your research dig around and find out more about the topic to really understand it if you need to, and more importantly, to fact check. But at least now you've got a structure you can follow and your research is a lot more focused, which is going to save you lots of time. Tip number four, brainstorming, which can be an enormous time saver with ChatGPT. And I've got a very detailed video about this with some super practical tips on my channel, so make sure you check out the link in the video description. Tip number five, creating outlines. Once you've brainstormed some ideas, you might need an outline, especially if you're writing something like a blog post, a video script, a marketing campaign, or a project plan. An outline is like a map for your writing. It helps you organize your thoughts and make sure that you don't forget anything. So I'm going to ask ChatGPT to create an outline, and of course it's going to be a very basic prompt, but just to demonstrate to you what it can do, we're just going to do something really basic. So create an outline for an article about the benefits of strength training. So it's given me a suggested title, which I can of course take and adapt. I can ask ChatGPT to provide 5 or 10 alternative titles focusing on different areas. So I've got something to choose from. I've got an outline of an introduction, and then chapters and paragraphs underneath each chapter. So it's quite a useful outline that will give you a basic structure that you can work with, and it will save you a lot of time because now you can think about the creative elements that go inside it instead of getting bogged down in the details of designing the structure. Tip number six, first drafts. And of course, you can ask ChatGPT to create a first draft for you for anything. So let's ask ChatGPT to come up with a first draft of a LinkedIn post about 3 skills workers should focus on in the age of AI. So of course, this is not going to be a perfect post because it's not going to use the voice that you usually use on LinkedIn, but it will give you a basic draft that you can work with. It's not too bad. It's actually got some emojis, it's got some headings, it's nicely structured, and it's got some hashtags as well to give you an idea of what you can actually produce. It's not going to be perfect. It might be bland. It might sound like a robot, but don't worry. I've got a separate video about how to make your AI generated content sound like a real person wrote it. So check out the link in the video description. Tip number seven, finding gaps in your content. Once you've produced something, you can read it again, edit it, and spend time thinking about what you may have missed. Or you can just ask ChatGPT. So I'm actually going to take the same article I wrote a few years ago, which I showed you in one of the previous examples. I'm going to put it through ChatGPT and I'm going to ask it, what did I miss in this article? So when I wrote this article about why startup founders should learn foreign languages, according to ChatGPT, I didn't touch on the cost and time investment involved in language learning. I didn't mention leveraging tech tools. I didn't talk about legal and regulatory insights. So these are just some suggestions. And if I don't think this is particularly useful, I can ask ChatGPT again to find out what other insights that I haven't mentioned I could focus on in my next piece of content. So as you can see, this is a very quick way to analyze the gaps that may exist in your content. Tip number eight, proofreading. Before you send anything to anyone, paste it into ChatGPT and ask, check this text for grammar, spelling, and punctuation mistakes. Tip number nine, writing and rewriting emails. This one is super useful because we all write emails, right? And emails can sometimes actually take quite a bit of time to write, especially if you need to communicate something difficult, or when you need to get buy-in from a senior colleague, or if you're trying to negotiate with a new client. It can really take ages to write them sometimes. So to make it quicker, you can of course use ChatGPT to draft the email. But what is even more useful is to ask it to adapt the tone For example, to make the email sound more friendly, more professional, or more authoritative, or whatever it is that you need. So you can write it in quite basic style and then put it through ChatGPT with a prompt like, make this email sound friendly and professional. So let's look at an example. So my email is gonna be, hi Joe, your report is really late. Can you send it to me tomorrow? Because otherwise, I won't be happy. Thanks. So obviously this is quite a harsh email. So I'm gonna ask ChatGPT to rewrite this email to sound friendly and professional. And let's see what it comes up with. Hi Joe, I hope you're doing well. That's a really nice way to start, to make it friendly. I wanted to kindly remind you that the report is overdue. Thanks so much for your attention to this. So it's given you a different version of the email with a slightly different tone. So this is particularly useful if you're writing a longer email where it would take you a lot of time to actually think about the style and the tone. And this really saves you lots of time. You can also make each email generated by ChatGPT sound more like you by feeding it some content that you have written in the past. I talk about the details of how to do this in my other video, which I have linked in the video description. So make sure you check it out. And the final tip is about creating templates. You don't have to start from scratch each time. You can ask ChatGPT to generate reusable templates for repeatable tasks that you do as part of your job all the time. For example, create a reusable template for writing product descriptions for an online shop. Give me a professional client email template for sending project updates. Or give me a LinkedIn post template for announcing a new product launch. This can really save you lots of time further down the line. If this video helped you, make sure you subscribe to my channel and leave me a comment. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you next time. Bye.